All right, guys, welcome back to a brand new episode of ARK on the Gaming... I didn't mean to poop. The Gaming Evolved Vanilla with Sprinkles server. And today we have big, big plans. I've got some cool stuff in my inventory, but first we gotta actually shave our beard because you know what? I like the dread beard, but I think I found a better combo. So let's grab out the scissors here and check this out. Wait, no, wrong one. It's this one. Okay. So, obviously, like, we have all of these hairstyles unlocked, and by the way, I still don't know what the other ones are. Apparently, there's some that you can unlock with Explorer Notes, but I don't really want to go around looking for all the Explorer Notes to figure it out. If you guys know, like, a list or anything that you could send me of all of the ones and what hairstyle I get from that, do you send that on? That would be appreciated. But, yeah, I actually figured out that, the romantic beard looks a lot better with the dreadlock hair. Look at that. That looks a lot better. I don't know. I just really like that. It looks really good. Now, obviously, like, I could probably, like, combine some other ones here. That one looks pretty cool, to be honest. But, like, this also looks kind of fun. I don't know. And that kind of looks good. I don't know. Like, there's so many good combos here. But we'll definitely be going with the dreadlock hair and the romantic beard, which is the one that you get from Valentine's Day if you collect all of the event pieces. And pretty soon here, actually, we should be getting like an Easter update, and I assume we're gonna get some sort of like extra thing for the Easter update or something like that. So we no longer have a beard now, and we're gonna have to wait for that to grow out. Man, that's gonna take a while. So let's start with the main thing for today. So I have in my inventory nine eggs. And we're gonna be incubating these things right now. Because we're going to be hatching up nine Rexes, because I need a Rex army, guys. I need an army for the Broodmother. We're going to get into the tech stuff here pretty soon. There is tech stuff in S+, which we can craft using the element and stuff that we'll get from the Broodmothers and stuff like that. So, yeah, we got to start making up an army here. I've already got four Rexes, but now we have another one. All right, let's give that guy some food and set him up. And I'm going to hatch another one now in a second. Man. No mutations, I don't think. No, didn't look like it anyway. All right, so let's just get you. Oh, did they just reset my key bindings again? They keep doing it, man. I hate this. There we go. That's like the fourth time I've done that this week. They keep resetting it for some reason. Okay, we're gonna bring this baby Rex over here. Come on, buddy. Wait, is that a male or a female? I never even checked. We'll just get them all over here, and then we'll bring them outside and start raising them out there. But, wait, did we disable wandering? Yeah, we did. So, wait, what are you, a male or a female? You're a female. That's really good. We need more females. So, let's go ahead and hatch another one here. Let's just drop two down. We'll pick one of them up just before. So, this one is going to hatch after this one. So, wait for it. And we'll pick up this one. Here we go. Twins? Triplets? No, just one. That's also fine. It's a male. And we're gonna give this thing some food. Can only take a little bit. Disable wandering. Change follow distance. And let's bring it over here. Gonna give you some more food, eh? Oh man, yeah. Can't forget about that. I got plenty of fish meat out in the feeding trough out there, but they gotta get to 10% before they can start taking that stuff. So, yeah, it's gonna take a little while. Alright, come on. Why are you so slow? We gotta take you off wandering. Or take you off follow even. So let me see the stats, actually. Are you kind of the same? Yeah, it looks like they kind of have the same health anyway. 2142, 337. 2142, 337. Yeah, they have the exact same stats. Holy crap. Nice. Oh, man, this thing's hungry. There you go, buddy. Okay, let's hatch up another one here. Let's just keep this train going. We got to have a lot of Rexes going at the same time here. It's best to kind of do them all at once, because then I can kind of just save time overall, because they don't take a hell of a lot of time to raise on our server for obvious reasons. Obviously, we have our breeding rates set really high, because we can't spend an absolute day making one video and still do other things on YouTube. It just doesn't make sense. So, yeah, we have that set pretty high, although I think most people understand that. So you gotta take you off wandering another male. Okay. 880, 2142. Oh, this one has better melee. Nice. Okay. Let's bring you over here. Leave you with the other ones. Whoa, don't go by the wall. What the hell are you doing? Oh, man. I don't even understand. All right, let's give this one some food as well. Gonna have to grab some more food from the trough. Why is it getting so slow when it gets here? So strange. Oh, whoa, why does that want... Oh, I thought that said wants care in 29 seconds. That was so strange. Okay. You good? Yeah, you're eating. You're all good. You're not dying or anything. Everything's good. All right. Let's drop it down some more here. So which ones are close? It actually says now, if you guys look in the little stat thing, just across from where it says weight, just below the egg, it says like incubation. So it gives like a percentage, which is really handy actually. So yeah, that was 4% incubated. So you didn't even have to drop them down to like basically check how much they're incubated. It will just tell you. Amazing, that's another Rex. Nice, give you some food. You got less health there. Okay, 21, 42, 337. Okay, so this is not a very good Rex, to be honest. Although in general, I mean, it's a pretty good Rex, but just in terms of like the other ones here, it's not the best. Either way, it's a female and I'm happy with it. That's 4 Rexes so far, guys, and we still haven't gotten any twins or anything like that. So maybe we will get some, hopefully, I'd say. That would be pretty handy. So we got 5 minutes left on an imprint, and this is going to be a lot of work today. Holy crap. We turned off wandering. Let's give you some more food. Got to give this guy a little bit of food. Do you have enough? Okay, yeah. I think they're all good for now. Let's drop down 2 eggs here. Try to get some done. You're on 12. Okay. We could probably just drop down 3 of those guys, and we'll just hatch one of them though. All right, this one's gonna hatch first, I'd say. Let's pick up this one now, and this one now, and this should hatch. Come on, I was hoping for like a mutation. I really want a mutation on one of these. I've never got a Rex mutation. They're not mutated at all, are they? No. Okay. So yeah, we gotta get you off of wandering, the same deal. Let's check your stats. 880, 2142, 337. Okay, so our highest melee one, actually I gotta go check and see if that is a mutation, because that possibly could be. And it's another male, so that's 3 males and 2 females, okay. Let's get you unfollow and bring you over here. I gotta check that one. I think it was the 3rd Rex that we hatched had the higher melee, so that could be a stat mutation, potentially. And if it is, then we want to obviously breed that mutation into some more that we already have here. So that would be the 3rd one here. No mutation, okay, and you are the one with the higher. Okay, so fair enough, that's just come from the parents. I don't actually have the stats of the parents because that was a long time ago. But we can kind of just keep track here of mutations. If it has like a really different stat, we can probably figure it out from there. Let's just check all the foods. I think they're all pretty good. All right, this is another Rex now. We have one egg that's at like 1%, I think. This one here, that should hatch any second now. No mutation, damn it. I really want like a pink or blue or orange or something Rex. An orange Rex would look really cool, actually. Holy crap. All right, is that... Oh, it's another male. Damn, okay. Get you off of wandering. We gotta get you unfollow. And bring you over here. And we should get another one on... the incubation. Actually, you know what? I'll bring them over to the other side just so we can kind of keep them all in line. And we still haven't gotten twins or a mutation or anything, and that's like 6 Rexes. Man, that is... Okay. Alright. So, another egg. And I'm just doing this all on cam because I kind of figure people want to see all these Rexes being born. Especially if we get a mutation. Like, oh, that... Don't worry, that white's not a mutation. Let's give you a little bit of foods. And... What do you have? 2142, yeah, same stats as usual, and we gotta give you some more food. And check, change that, nice, bring you over to the line of them here. Man, look at all these Rexes. Let's take that thing off. Okay, and give this little guy some food as well. We gotta go get some more food now. I have it all out in the trough, should be pretty handy. Did I? Yeah, I did, sweet. Okay, so let me see, let's grab a bunch of that. I just went out on my Thyla and just grabbed like a huge amount of fish, just like killing all the fish in the river. I went down and killed some sharks too, and what are your, oh man, don't go to the front. Wow, that is so glitchy back there. It's like the evolution of Rexes here, look at that. It's like, this one's like the big one, and then like when you look down at the end, there's a massive difference between them. That's so cool looking. All right, so you're on a minute 47. I was about to say minute 19. Okay, yeah, we can probably get the other two done here, I'd say. All right, we can definitely get these two done really quick here. Oh, I didn't mean to pick that up. Okay, that's another male. Wow, come on, give me some females. If I have some females, that means that I can get some more breeding going here. No mutation, 880, yeah, same kind of stats. We've been getting them on every single rec so far. And let's change that. Nice, bring you over here. Gotta feed this one here. It's like, I'm like a well-oiled machine right now because like, it's just the process of getting all of these things done, making sure that I'm doing the exact same thing for every single rex, or else one of them could like mess up and die if I forget to feed it or whatever. Last rex here. So we got 7% on this. Okay. Please, this is the last chance. We want like a mutation or something. A giant orange rex would be amazing. Come on, give me a mutation. No mutations. Doesn't look like it anyway. All right, that's completely fine. What is this? Less health. 337. Yeah. Okay, so just less health on this one, and it's a female. So we got 3 females and 6 males. Man, I mean, we do want like an equal amount of males and females anyway, but like, at the same time, I would kind of like quite a few females just so I can get some more rexes going, because I don't want to just breed up and have only 20 rexes. I probably want to get more because I'm probably going to lose some in the arena. And the plan for leveling all these guys, you guys may be wondering, is leaving a Lystro beside them. I am not going out on every single rex and then doing that. Oh, we got a cuddle. Nice. I'm not going out on every single individual rex and doing that. That would be an absolute nightmare. So yeah. A lot of these guys have higher timers, so what do you guys, you got like 3 minutes, 1 minute. Okay, cool. So that looks really cool. 9 rexes and we didn't even get any twins. Wow. Okay, you know what, hopefully we'll get some more in the next batch, but we're gonna get some of these things bred up or imprinted up now. It's gonna be a long time. I'll probably bring you guys back for like little status updates and stuff like that, but in general, I'll probably see you guys in a little bit. Okay guys, so it's a long while later now, and I have a bunch more eggs because we let all the rexes raise up, and then we bred them once more with the previous ones as well, so we got 7 eggs in total. I think I said that we got 4 or 3 females and 6 males earlier, but actually it was 4 females and 5 males. Out of the 9. So let's give this baby some foods. This one's a male. Okay, not giving me very many females here. It's okay though. All right, so I'm gonna actually, no, I'll leave that bit for later. So let me just change this thing. What stats do you have? What was it again? Yeah, I think these are the same as earlier. Yeah, we're not getting any different type stats right now. Let's move this little baby over here and get another one going. Oh, this is a hell of a day, guys. Holy crap. Just tons of imprinting. It's okay though, because like I can pretty much just like chill back and like watch some videos or like whatever. I was kind of just watching some TV shows there while we were doing that whole thing. It took ages. Oh man. All right, here we go. And the worst part is actually when you're breeding them and you have to wait around for them to like lay the egg. It takes ages. It really does. Like, I think there should be some way to speed that up. I just don't like waiting in the game. It's just, when you have to stop the game and just like wait for something to happen, I feel like that's not fun. I don't know, maybe that's just me. Let's get this little baby on follow. We should actually start changing the names now as well. I just have that copied because I was doing that for all of them. Let's give you some more foods. Nice, and get you over here too on follow. I'll give him some more foods and name him in a second. So we got 7 more eggs, so that's 2 so far. I'd never actually even checked if they were males or females. So the first one was a male, I believe. This one was a female. Cool. So that means we have, how many is that? 8 females in total now? Okay, come on. Give me like twins or like mutated ones or something good. Okay, just one single one. That's okay. That's another one of those white ones. Okay, let me get you to all of the things. Oh, man. We have so many rexes, guys. We have, after this, we'll have exactly 20, but we want to make more. We don't want to just, like, I want to have, like, a huge amount of eggs still going here, because I don't want to, like, bring in all the rexes, and in case something happens, like, and if I die, everything dies. So I don't want to bring in all the rexes and then fail, basically. So we gotta be pretty careful here. I want to get like at least maybe 30 to 40 eggs before we head in. Like, so it's gonna be a little bit till we actually head into the arena. Don't expect us to be going in like immediately after we have all these Rexes, because I gotta be smart about this. I really do. Okay, another egg here. We'll just took down a couple here because I think they have quite high incubation still. So we'll pick up this one here. I'll pick up this one. 3, 2, 1, unpick it up. Let's get this one. Nice. You're another female. Awesome. Okay. Because like more females means that it's gonna take less time to get all the eggs. He got the higher melee stat. Nice. Okay. Let's take you off of Wander. Do all the things. So we're probably not gonna name most of these Rexes. I have like 4 Rexes that I named. Like, I don't really feel like naming like 20 to 30 odd Rexes. It just really doesn't make very much sense. So I'm just gonna have them all as just called Sin, essentially. Like my little tag, so people know it's mine. And so people can see them all dying and know that it's me dying in the Broodmother Arena. Alright, let's give all these guys some foods. You got some foods. Do you need some more foods? Let's give you some, and you could do a little bit more, and then we're good. Alright. Okay, let me see. So we have 3 more eggs, or is it 4 more? Yeah, 3 more eggs. That one's gonna hatch immediately. Just drop down 2. Oh, whoa, whoa, whoa. We got twins. Nice. I get you. Okay. Let me give you some foods. Oh, crap. And give you some as well. Alright. Disable wandering. Disable wandering. Follow. You're on lowest. I don't want you to be on lowest. I want you to be on low. Oh, crap. There we go. Sweet. Okay. Let's get them over here. Sweet. So we got twins there. I wonder if they have better stats or anything, if there are mutated stats. Never even had a look. Nope. Pretty much the same with the low melee. I mean, I could specifically breed to get the high melee, but like, really doesn't matter that much to me. Just keep doing this. So, how many is that now? That is out of the, what is that, 5 eggs, and so far we have 6 Rexes, so one pair of twins, or not a pair, yeah, not a pair of twins, one twins. One set of twins, that's the word. Alright, sweet. So, what do we got here? Come on, be mutated, be triplets. Mutated triplets would look really cool. Come on, be mutated. Oh, okay, just one. It's a male. Give him some foods. Oh, don't want to unclaim him even. And we gotta set you on Wander. Or, no, we gotta set you on this thing, not Wander. Alright. Man, so many Rexes. I don't even know. I'm gonna run out of space for all these guys. Luckily, I have a pretty big base here, but probably still gonna run out of space at some point. Is he on? Did I not? Ah, oh, damn it. The one time. Stay still, please. Alright, let me see. What am I doing? Giving food. Oh, crap. I'm getting stuck on a tail here. Oh, my god. Okay, we're okay. Let's give you some more as well. Right, one more egg, guys. This is the final egg. Hopefully we'll get something. Mutated triplets. Mutated triplets with all of them female. Come on. Okay, oh, whoa, whoa, whoa. Is it? No, it's twins. Okay, I thought it was triplets for a second. They're not mutated, though. Damn, I really want a mutation. Give me a mutation, please. All right, they have the lower health. Crap. Okay. So let me see. Oh, I set them on lowest. Crap. Okay, let me... It's kind of awkward when there's 2 of them. Alright, stop. You go on low. You go on low. Have I disabled wandering on both of them? I think I have, and they're male and female. Okay, cool. Let's bring them over here. So how many is that now? We hatched 7 eggs. We got a pair of twins. So yeah, that means that we have 9 Rexes here to go. So maybe basically today, we've just raised 16... No, that's 18 Rexes. 18 Rexes today. Holy crap. Let me see. Oh, man. Okay. Well, this means more imprinting, guys. This means more kibbles and walks and everything, and it's so awkward with the walks when there's several of them at the same time. I almost didn't get an imprint on one of them there. Oh no, what am I doing? Why are you still on follow? No whistle group. Why were they still following me? Okay, never mind. Yeah, I almost didn't get an imprint on one of them over there, but I managed to get all of them imprinted. Hopefully I'll have the same luck with these ones over here. It really does get awkward when there's so many of them. I could probably use with somebody else just over here just to help me out with this, because we have the thing, so tribes can basically do that. So if anybody's in my tribe, they can help me imprint. Like, if I ever needed to go offline, I guess I could get somebody to come over and take care of my guys here. So what do we got? The tails are so glitchy. We got 2 minutes on you. These ones aren't as neat as well. They're like kind of all over the place. Right, so I will spend some time, get all these things imprinted, maybe watch a movie. So yeah, I guess we'll be back in a long while with another lot of Rexes. And wait, how many females did we get? We got one female so far. What are you in the back? Two females, three, four females at a 9. We've mostly been getting males. Damn. Alright, so we will be back in a little bit anyway. Guys, we're back and I hatched up 3 new T-Rexes and we freaking got a mutated one right here. And I just loaded into the game, so I think like we're still a little bit like framey and glitchy. But look at this thing. It got the good health, it got the good stamina, although I don't think any of them have gotten any lower stamina, and it got the good melee. And it's freaking mutated. Look at that. It literally just got it from this one right here and Neptune. Oh my god. This thing looks fantastic. I actually had to load completely out of the game because I streamed earlier and I forgot to switch up my recording settings, blah, 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 blah. I needed to fix that. So we're back on now and it's actually the next day. We had kind of an issue. Basically, the server rolled back. I wasn't doing anything like loading in areas or like causing massive lag or anything on the server, but there was others on and maybe they were, I'm not exactly sure. We're not exactly sure about the whole situation, but either way, the server rolled back yesterday for a couple hours and it kind of messed up my recording. So this video was actually supposed to come out on Wednesday, but unfortunately it's coming out on Thursday now, and not so unfortunate because I didn't have this yesterday. This is like brand new. I have 9 eggs in here now. I think it's 9, right? Yeah, there they are. So I actually hatched up all those guys and they were like mostly grown, and then the server rolled back, so I lost all that and I was just too tired and I was just kind of thinking like, yeah, I kind of want to go to bed. So yeah, I kind of messed up on that. But anyway, I'm sorry that we didn't get a vanilla out on Wednesday, but either way, we're getting this and now we have a freaking mutated Rex. This thing looks amazing. It is a male though, which is kind of disappointing. What do we need? What do we need? Dodo eggs. Yes, we have Dodo. Dodo. Amazing. I'll just take one, because I don't like taking more out, because I keep forgetting to put it back in. My game's still really framey from that load-in. Oh, I guess we'll imprint this one as well. I love the little emote that they do. So yeah, we're going to have to get a full imprint on that guy. Come on, buddy. We're going to have to get a full imprint, and definitely try to breed it up with some of the other ones. I want to get a couple of them. I don't want to use that one in the arena. I want to get a couple of them with that mutation. And what am I doing? And then we'll probably bring some of them into the arena. Maybe like I'll ride on one that is this color in the arena or something. I'm not exactly sure. All right, so you got 8 minutes. The other one had 10 minutes. You've got a couple more minutes here. You look freaking amazing. Let me know, guys. I've seen a lot of Rex mutations. Tweet them at me. Tweet them at me because I love seeing them. What's it called? I know a lot of people follow me on Twitter already, but we're almost at 1,000 subscribers. followers. We're like 900 or so right now. So let's try and get that up a little bit. You know, I do tweet out a lot of news and stuff to do with the channel on Twitter, like different things like specs and stuff. Oh, you're just losing health for some reason. I don't know why. I tweet out like news and stuff to do with the channel on there. It's the best way to kind of get across to a lot of people. So definitely follow me on there and tweet me your mutations, because, well, your dino mutations. I don't want to see real life ones. So yeah, because like I really like seeing them. There's a lot of awesome looking creatures out there, and I really want to see what you guys already have, because I know a lot of people are jealous of my Thyla, and I've seen a lot of other Thylas that I'm kind of jealous of because they look amazing. What do you need, buddy? So yeah, tweet them at me and follow me on there too, at SyntechYT, but there's also links down below. Let's get you on a follow. Let's bring it over here. Still kind of framey, just gotta load in the whole base. And then I should be good. Are you coming? Where are you going? Oh, you are coming. Hey, look at you, little Stompy. And there you go. Right, so we're going to continue with this. I have more Rexes to breed, so that's going to be a whole thing. We're going to get these things raised up, and I'll see you guys in a little bit. Okay, so we are back, and this Rex is fully grown. Ooh. This thing looks epic. Okay, let's get some kills in this. Oh my god. It's like golden. I know it's yellowy, but like it almost looks like it's gold. Oh my god, there's so many good things over here to kill. We're having real problems loading in the area. I mean, I've been at just specifically at my base for like ages now, so I don't know. Maybe there's something laggy around. Oh man. We're just unstoppable. Look at this. Ah, mutated dinos look so awesome. Unfortunately, he didn't get a stat mutation. That would have been really nice. Like, another, like, a melee mutation, that would be ideal. Like, just to get more melee, or maybe even health mutation or something. Oh my god. Alright, let's get you killed. Come back here, buddy. Hey. The good part about this one is that it actually is a male. So that means I could breed this one with all of my females and possibly maybe get like a second mutation. I don't know. We could see. Ugh. Oh man. And also the fact that it has the higher melee stat means that it's going to definitely pass. Well, it's most likely going to pass them onto the babies. And we want the babies. They don't have to be golden like this one, but they need to have that higher melee stat. Now, I realized that at the very start, we were just randomly breeding. Now I want to actually breed for that stat. It's a better stat. I want to breed it into all of my new Rexes. So in future, we will be doing that. But I need to get a female version of this one to call it Athena, which is kind of like my universal Rex, best Rex name, essentially. So probably going to have to breed up one of those at some point. Maybe we're going to, I guess we could keep breeding and try to get like a different mutation. If we get something like somewhere else, like the bit on the back, or where else can Rexes get mutations? The bit on the back, maybe those little spikes along its legs too, I think, as well can get a mutation. I'm not sure. Ooh, whoa, we had just a sound glitch really quick there. Holy crap. Ooh, okay, come on. Get both of you. No, you're running away. Okay, fair enough. And there's a stego in the mix too. Oh man, this is awesome. I can't believe we got like a yellow mutation. I don't think I've gotten a yellow mutation. Oh, we're having a server save. Oh, there we go. Yeah, I don't think I've gotten a yellow mutation, so this is really awesome. Like, ah, looks really cool. Oh man, okay, come on. You must be a high level Bronto. What level are you? Can't even tell. Oh my god. Okay, well that one was a level 6, and you were a 156. Okay, yeah, so it was a high level. Sweet. How much? Okay, we got a good few levels here, actually. Health. Specifically. Oh my god. Specifically health. For the reason of, I've seen, like, methods on how to take down the Broodmother and Megapithecus and all them, blah 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 blah. From what I've seen is that, like, Rexes will die unless you give them health. You gotta level health, specifically. If you level melee, you're gonna get less health. Your guy is gonna do more damage per hit, but he's going to last, like, he's not gonna last as long. And that's the main point. You wanna last as long as you can, because, like, if a bunch of your Rexes are dying at the very start because they have a higher melee stat, that means that there's less damage per second. So, like, if we can keep 20 Rexes alive for the majority of the fight, that's gonna be really awesome, because that means that we can probably kill this thing. So my method when we go into the arena is, I'll keep one Rex for myself off to the side, and I'll send all of the other Rexes at the Broodmother and at its minions. Now, I want you guys to let me know, do the pheromone darts, you know, the aggro darts, do they work on the bosses? Because if they do, I need to also bring them. But my main plan is for me to just be there with a, probably an ascendant assault rifle. My ascendant assault rifle will probably come in with me, and a crap ton of ammo to last me 15 minutes. Maybe a couple other things. We're probably going to bring like a bunch of health potions, like stews and all that good stuff, a bunch of water, because I know it gets hot in that arena, and there's only one water spot. Oh my god, there's a Quetzal. Can't even see. There's only one water spot in the arena, and it's right below the Broodmother's little bridge thingy, so we don't really want to have to go down there, because there's usually baby spiders get knocked down there. Anyway, so my plan is assault rifle, bunch of stews, blah blah blah. Is the assault rifle the best weapon, guys? Let me know. Is it the best weapon for per, like, to get damage per second? What the hell? Whose Quetzal is this? Oh, what the hell? Huh. Why was that called Evo? I'm gonna have to ask about that. Why was that? I don't really understand. Okay, let me kill this thing. I wasn't sure why that Quetzal was over here, actually. That's kind of strange. I don't understand. Huh, okay. Anyway, yeah, let me know about the whole situation with the arena. Is it best to use a compound bow, or is it best to use an assault rifle? I really don't want to use a shotgun. Maybe it does more damage, but I'd have to be closer, and that's just not going to happen. So, is it going to be the assault rifle, or is it the bow? Let me know that question, because that's going to be handy information, because I don't want to bring in one when the other's better. I want to bring in the best thing. So, yeah, do please let me know about all that good stuff. Oh my god, we're just taking down everything here. We are an unstoppable king of Ark. We are the Golden Rex. So awesome. Alright. I could get that beaver dam, but I don't want to. Actually, you know what? We probably should have checked to see if there was anything on that Quetzal. There was a saddle, so I guess I can grab that. Who's CP again? I think that, yeah, that's Albanac, actually. CP is Albanac. Because it's Crackpot is his character's name. Let me go over and check. I don't know why I didn't just check it, to be honest. Whoa. This has a lot of good stuff on it. I am so lucky I checked. What is all this? Oh my god. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Man, okay. Oh, stay still. Holy crap. Why does he have all this stuff on here? He must have been moving a bunch of his stuff. I'm gonna... Oh, crap. I guess I don't need that. I'm gonna drop the oil. I can probably pick up the rest. I don't know what all this is doing here, but I guess I'm gonna have to need to get this back to him. That is a lot of awesome stuff, though. Why is it just out here? I'm so confused. An ascended Giga Saddle? Man. I bet you guys want me to tame one of those. Okay. I'm gonna transfer all these. Okay, well, I'm gonna figure out what the deal is with that Quetzal. But, yeah, guys, if you enjoyed this video, be sure to beat the crap out of that like button. If you guys want to see more like this, you know what to do. You gotta subscribe, that's how it works, and hit that little bell button down below as well. The little bell basically means that you'll get notifications, which means that you won't miss a video, but also a great way of not missing a video is follow me on Twitter. Oh, we just killed a 180 Overraptor, nice. Yeah, follow me on Twitter, because the tweets automatically go out whenever I post on YouTube, so yeah. Do that. Anyway, I will see you next time.